Princess and the Packet of Frozen Peas. Oh. It's by Tony Wilson and Sue DeGiro. Once upon a time, there was a prince called Hendrik. And he wanted very much to fall in love and get married.
I am an outdoorsy type, and I hope to find the princess that I will marry and that she will like camping and hockey.
Now, there were many girls who wanted to marry a prince. Every time Hendrik left the palace, groups of screaming girls would yell,
"Hi, Hendrik! Oh, hi! How are you, Hendrik? Oh, you're so dreamy, Hendrik! Oh, I love
it!" And they throw flowers in his general direction. And so Hendrik decided he would ask his brother for some advice.
I think I'll ask Prince Hans for some advice. Hey, bro, how you doing?
Good.
I just wanted to ask you some advice. So what do you want to know? Tell me about some princesses.
Okay, the most important thing about princesses is they have to be real princesses. Now, a real princess is very beautiful and very sensitive. When I met my wife, Eva, I tell you, I stacked 20 mattresses and 20 elder down quilts, and I put one single pea under the bottom mattress. And you know what? If a girl complains about feeling a single pea under all those mattresses and all those quilts, she must be a real princess.
So did Princess Ava complain?
You bet. She complained a lot.
Prince Hendrik decided that he'd watch Princess Eva to see what a real princess was like.
I'm waiting for her to show up. I'm hidden and ready to watch.
He found her at the tennis court, where she was being sensitive about the tennis balls.
These balls are too bouncy. I don't like it. I want others. I want them in pink.
So he followed her over to the driveway, and there he saw her. She was being sensitive about her new sports car.
This is not the car that I wanted. I wanted the one with the drink holder and yellow. Ugh, can anybody get anything right?
Prince Hendrik wondered whether perhaps Princess Eva was a little too sensitive.
I have decided that I will don't want to marry a real princess. Not a princess like Prince Eva. I want to marry the exact opposite. She doesn't have to be beautiful, definitely not sensitive. She just has to like hockey and have a nice smile.
And so Prince Hendrik came up with a plan. Whenever a girl came to stay, he offered to make up the guest room. Instead of 20 mattresses, Prince Hendrik just put one thin camping mattress on. And instead of 20 eiderdown quilts, he just found one old sleeping bag. And instead of a single pea, the prince decided to use a whole packet of frozen peas. Many girls visited, but none passed that test.
You won't believe it. I found peas in my bed. Peas! I couldn't sleep at all. There was this massive lump under the mattress. I mean, like, what's the deal with the frozen peas anyway?
And then one morning, Prince Hendrik's old friend, Pippa, she came to stay.
Hey, Pippa, how you doing?
Good. Everybody had a great day. They rode horses.
I sing. Oh, whoa.
And they even spied on Princess Eva as she complained about everything in the palace.
You know, if she's a real princess, I want to marry the complete opposite.
Hendrik and Pippa laughed. And for the first time, Prince Hendrik noticed what a lovely laugh Pippa had. And The following morning, Hendrik sat and waited for Pippa to wake up. He waited, waited, and waited. And finally, Pippa emerged, yawning.
Ah, Selma, how'd you sleep?
Oh, I slept wonderfully, but I found this. It was great. I had a little bit of a sore knee from playing hockey. It was the greatest ice pack ever.
And Pippa beamed back. She had a lovely gap between her teeth.
Will you marry me?